Hello people, in this video let us look at fetal circulation and try to understand. Okay, so basically what are we going to look at? The blood circulation in fetus. Okay, it's also called as prenatal circulation. Okay, here what you should understand is the fetal lungs are not functional. The lungs of a fetus are not functional. The source of oxygen for the fetus is the placenta, and mother's blood does not cross the placenta. Okay. So, here you have the placenta, okay, the mother's blood comes here, right, the placenta sends only the oxygen, right, to the fetus, okay. So, the lungs of the fetus are not working, the oxygen is directly supplied to the fetus by the placenta, okay. So, this is the mother's blood does not flow to the fetus, okay. So, did you understand this part of it? What is fetal circulation? We are looking at the blood circulation in fetus. This is also called as prenatal circulation because it is before the birth. Fetal lungs are not functional. The source of oxygen is placenta, and the mother's blood does not cross the placenta. Okay. So placenta as such has so many layers, right? You have syncytial trophoblast, cytotrophoblast, and then endothelium of the fetal blood vessel, okay, and its basement membrane. So let's say this is the fetal blood vessel, right? Then you have cytotrophoblast, syncytial trophoblast. Here you'll have the maternal blood, isn't it? This is how the the nutrients will flow to the baby. What is actually coming? Oxygen and nutrients. So the placenta, what and all does it allow? It allows the oxygen, water, electrolytes, nutrition, right, like carbohydrates, lipids, polypeptides, amino acids, vitamins, and even IgG. This is very important. IgG, immunoglobulins, right? It also allows this immunoglobulins, right? How's it going so far, guys? Is it making sense to you? So, what and all crosses the placenta, you have understood. Oxygen, water, electrolytes, nutrition, IgG. Okay? So, there are some numericals here. You can look at it. So, this is the amount of oxygen per minute. So, basically, the mother will have the hemoglobin, adult hemoglobin, okay? Mother will have adult hemoglobin, either HbA or Hb, whatever, okay? And fetus, the fetus will have HbF. The thing is, the hemoglobin of the fetus is much more powerful than the hemoglobin of the adult. So, it pulls the oxygen towards it, okay? The fetal hemoglobin is more powerful. It pulls the oxygen. This placenta also does the job of removing things from the fetus. Okay. So, it removes what and all? Urea, carbon dioxide, waste products, etc. Okay. And placenta is a barrier. It will not allow what? It will not allow the maternal blood. Right. It will not allow the maternal blood. So, fetus is on this side. It will not allow the maternal blood. It will not allow bacteria. Most of the bacteria, most of the virus, maternal hormones also, it will not allow most of them. Okay. So, all these it will not allow. So, understand this one. What is this? This is the placenta. Here you have the maternal, and this entire thing, what is depicted here is the fetus. Okay. This entire thing is the fetal circulation. Here you have maternal blood coming here. Placenta is supplying what? It's supplying the oxygen. Okay. So, understand this pathway. Okay. So, look at this, guys. It's pretty clear, right? From the placenta, it is going like this to the heart. Heart, it doesn't have to go to the lungs, right? So, there is no work of lungs here. So, it directly goes to the left chambers and it gets pumped to the entire body. And then via the umbilical arteries, it is going to the back to the placenta. See, umbilical vein is here. Okay, it is carrying oxygenated blood. Because veins go to heart. Arteries leave the heart. So, in this case, the vein is bringing oxygenated blood to the fetal heart. Umbilical vein is carrying oxygenated blood. So, guys, now we will ask you questions and you will say, where is the placenta? Okay, so where is the placenta? Yes, that is the placenta. So, where is the umbilical vein? Yes, that is the umbilical vein. Next, inferior vena cava. Okay. then directly the blood is going from right heart to left heart. Direct connection is there. That is not there in you. Correct, right? In you, that's not there. Then from where does it go? From the left atrium to the left ventricle. Depicted by that white arrow. So you can see here, it came from placenta, umbilical vein, some mysterious connection to inferior vena cava. Inferior vena cava will drain to right heart even in you. That is no difference. But from right heart directly it's going to left heart. That is another mysterious connection. So one mysterious connection here of the umbilical vein, one mysterious connection here from the right to the left heart, then normal from left atrium to the left ventricle. Then what happens? Then obviously it gets from the left ventricle, pumps it into the aorta, right? And from aorta, where does it go? Blood supply to the body. Then another mysterious connection here, umbilical arteries. Umbilical arteries will take the blood back to the placenta. Okay, so just review here again. Placenta, umbilical vein. Umbilical vein has to mysteriously join the inferior vena cava. So it joins with the portal vein, right? Umbilical vein joins with the portal vein. That will anyways go to the inferior vena cava. From there, right to left heart, then left atrium to left ventricle. Left ventricle pumps to aorta. Then blood supply to the body. Then umbilical arteries. There are two umbilical arteries, but only one umbilical vein. Okay. So those are the lungs which are not functional yet. Small amount of blood supply is present, but there's no air. Okay. Now let us look at the three mysterious things that make this possible. One is this umbilical vein connecting to the inferior vena cava, that is to the portal vein. Umbilical vein to the portal vein actually. So umbilical vein to the portal vein is by ductus venosus. This is one shunt that is there in the fetus. Then, which is the other shunt? The right to the left heart. Very good. That is foramen ovale. This is yet another shunt. Okay, this is the second shunt that you should know. Then where is the third shunt? The third shunt is here, ductus arteriosus. So here, what is happening? Whatever is getting into the, there is a connection here between the aorta and the pulmonary trunk, isn't it? So that is ductus arteriosus. What is that? Blood flows from pulmonary trunk to aorta. It flows to the aorta. Guys, so did you understand these three mysterious shunts that are present in a fetus to make sure that the blood flows from the placenta, right? The fetal blood flows in such a way that it is mysterious from us. We don't have these three shunts. From umbilical vein to the portal vein. Then from the right heart to left heart. Imagine if you have this kind of a hole, it will be a septal defect, right? But the fetus has it. And then pulmonary trunk to the aorta. So these are the three mysterious shunts you should know. Ductus venosus, foramen ovale, and ductus arteriosus. Ductus venosus, ductus arteriosus, foramen ovale. Okay. So name the three shunts of fetal circulation. Ductus venosus, ductus arteriosus, and foramen ovale. So ductus venosus, foramen ovale, and ductus arteriosus. Very good. Now, let us look at the fetal circulation completely again with the shunts. Placenta, umbilical vein, it goes via the ductus venosus to portal vein. From there, it goes to the inferior vena cava. There, it goes to right heart to left, right atrium to left atrium via the foramen ovale. Then, from left ventricle, it goes to aorta. Whatever is there in pulmonary trunk gets redirected to aorta. That is ductus arteriosus. Then blood supply to the body, two umbilical arteries will return the blood to the placenta. Okay. So now what happens? When is all this happening? Okay. This is the timeline of fetal circulation. Till birth it will be like this. Now what happens immediately at birth? At birth. Okay. Now so where we are? At birth. Right. So what happens at birth? So at birth, the foramen ovale will close. So where was the foramen ovale? It was between the right heart and the left heart. So the foramen ovale which was there, now it will close. So one shunt gone, guys. One shunt is gone. Now how does it close? Because the lungs will function, the lungs will send back blood, and that it will have more pressure, this will close. Okay. So look at this. So immediate changes at birth. So the umbilical vein will get occluded, umbilical arteries, they contract. Okay, so these are the changes. Then what happens? There is more blood to the lungs. So ductus arteriosus also gets occluded. Guys, please pay attention here. There are the three shunts you have to pay attention to. Umbilical vein, umbilical artery, we told you what happens. Coming to ductus arteriosus, it will occlude. Where was ductus arteriosus? If this is the arch of aorta, there was a ductus arteriosus. It gets occluded here. So the blood will rather go where? To the lungs now, right? So lungs will start oxygenating and sending the blood back to the left atrium. Now the pressure there will increase. So there will be more pressure in left atrium. So the foramen ovale will close. So these are the changes. Okay. At birth. Let's move on. At birth, foramen ovale closure. Then, now you understood that the foramen ovale closed, right? Now what happens to the other two shunts? What were the other two shunts? Ductus venosus, ductus arteriosus. Ductus arteriosus also, they told you it will occlude. Let us look at the remnants of these, okay? So where are we now? Ductus venosus, liver, behind the liver. So they have shown you posterior view of liver. Behind the liver, something is there. What is there? Ligamentum venosum, so easy. Ductus venosus is becoming ligamentum venosum. Ductus arteriosus is becoming, what is it becoming? They have shown a small here. Ligamentum arteriosum, see, ductus is replaced with ligamentum. Ligamentum venosum, ligamentum arteriosum, okay. Then what happens to foramen ovale? Foramen ovale is closed, okay. Then umbilical vein remnant is there. Ligamentum teres, that becomes, then umbilical arteries, what happens to umbilical arteries? They are there somewhere here, okay. Let's see that. They are becoming medial umbilical ligaments, okay guys. So did you understand the remnants? So you have, they have not told you only the remnants of the ductus venosus, ductus arteriosus. They are also telling you the remnants of umbilical vein and umbilical arteries. Okay, ligamentum is one word you have to remember. Ligamentum venosum, ligamentum arteriosum, ligamentum teres. Here there is some medial umbilical ligaments, two, because two arteries were there. So behind the liver, what and all you should see? You should see the ligamentum venosum and you should see ligamentum teres. Teres is umbilical vein, isn't it? And ligamentum venosum is from ductus venosus. Remnants these are. Ligamentum arteriosum is from ductus arteriosus. Then, medial umbilical ligaments coming from where? The umbilical arteries. Now, ligamentum teres is remnant of umbilical vein. Correct. It's a remnant of umbilical vein. Then, this is the ligament teres. They're showing again and again. Now, clinical aspects. This is the probe foramen ovale and patent foramen ovale. Probe foramen ovale, it will open only when you put a probe, okay. But patent foramen ovale, if it is open, then that can become an atrial septal defect, ASD, okay. So actually foramen ovale should close at birth, which can be probed possibly, but patent is something that is causing a defect, atrial septal defect. Then, so the summary, we have reached the end of this video. So, what did we see in this video? We saw everything about placenta, basically the how, what placenta does, what a barrier it is, what it allows, what it removes from fetus. Then fetal circulation pathway, we saw that fetal circulation pathway, this is the one we saw. Then there are shunts, three shunts, which are them? Ductus venosus, ductus arteriosus and foramen ovale. Now at birth, foramen ovale closes, that you saw. Then what happens? Remnants. Let's look at the remnants. Ligamentum venosum, ligamentum arteriosum. These two are the remnants. And foramen ovale is foramen ovale itself. Then other remnants of umbilical vein, ligamentum teres, umbilical arteries, some medial umbilical ligaments. Okay. So that's all for now in this video on fetal circulation. Hope you have understood something from this video. Bye, people.